And welcome to this Proactive Investors One-to-One Investor Forum. My name is Sarah Lowther, and tonight it's a first. And in years to come, when your grandchildren ask you where you were on the evening of Thursday, March 26, 2020, you can say, I was at home. Well, I'm delighted to see how many of you have registered. I can see regulars. I can see my favourites, you know who you are, and I can see lots of my colleagues from Proactive Investors, which is great because we're guaranteed to have lots of intelligent, meaningful, relevant questions. Now, speaking of colleagues, 2 weeks ago, I know that many of you were very concerned about our events director, Tom Coleman, who was a bit poorly, and I know Mary, you in particular, always ask after him. Well, don't worry, because I have in fact heard from Tom. He's in the cloud, not a heavenly cloud, just the cloud, and he's much better. In fact, he is surrounding us and moderating this event. Okay, so to the format, there are two companies presenting this evening. So I'm hoping to wrap up just after 7 o'clock this evening. First of all, we've got feedback followed by Silence Therapeutics. It is the same format as the in-person events that we host at the Chesterfield and the brewery. So it's 20 minutes per presenter. At 19 minutes, I will do a, you've got a 1 minute left prompt, and then it's 10 minutes Q&A from you. What we're going to do is we're going to enable chat just towards the end of each presentation, and then you can ask your questions. So be precise, be concise, and be polite. If you're rude, I will throw you out of the presentation. So really, nothing's changed. Also, do stay right to the very end, because I have two very important announcements that I want to share with you. Okay, time now is 1 minute past six. First up, feedback. It's a specialist medical imaging technology company. The firm's bleeper technology allows medical grade images to be shared securely on phones and tablets. It has come up with some very relevant news today. The company is listed on the main board of the London Stock Exchange, and its market cap of today is £1.9 million. Tom Oakley is the chief executive. Tom.
So I just wanted to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Tom Oakley. I'm the CEO of Feedback Medical. My clinical background is actually as a radiologist, and does and specializes in. We, as Feedback, are a company who have specialized in medical imaging since 2001. We provide a system called PACS, which is effectively an imaging library. And we provide that to four NHS trusts and have done for a long period of time. And we have, in the last year, repurposed that technology to produce a brand new product called Bleeper that allows clinicians to engage with medical imaging studies from any locality based from any device. And I move to the next screen. Okay. This is a sort of photo capture of what Bleeper looks like and the functionality that it allows us to deliver to clinicians. So, at the minute in a hospital, it is very difficult for clinical studies such as CT scans or x-rays or MRIs to actually be shared between team members, even within a hospital, especially when individuals in that hospital are having to work remotely from home. So what we have done is repurposed our PACS software to enable us to share images flexibly onto mobile devices. So what Bleeper does is it allows you to review CT scans, MRIs, ultrasounds, x-rays, in fact, any type of medical imaging study from wherever you are. But then it also allows you to chat through an instant messaging system to the rest of the clinical team. This is a really important functionality. It allows us to have dialogue with clinicians, even when we are spread geographically. Now, this has become particularly important in our current situation with coronavirus, in that a number of clinicians who are delivering care at the clinical front line are going to have to be forced to self-isolate and deliver care from home, particularly those who are well and have to self-isolate. What Bleeper will allow us to deliver as part of this response is to allow senior clinicians who have to work from home to be able to support junior colleagues who are on the front line. They will be able to support with image interpretation, case-based discussion, and clinical decision-making, which will allow them to continue contributing to the care of patients even if they are forced to self-isolate. We have designed Bleeper to operate as a series of patient-specific chats. It's really important that we delineate by patient so that we always are talking about the same individual. When you're dealing with caseloads of up to 100 patients individually, it can become very confusing. So it's key that we have that functionality. The patient flow is such that a patient will arrive in hospital. A patient episode will be created on Bleeper. Everyone involved in the care of that patient, wherever they are located, will be invited into the conversation about that patient. Everyone will be able to review that patient's medical images. They will be able to annotate those images and ask questions directly from the image to everyone else in the conversation. When a specialist opinion is needed, you can add specialists into the chat in order to get that specialist expertise at a time that you need it. You don't have to page anyone, you don't have to phone, you don't have to go through hospital switchboard, you just invite them into the conversation. And this is particularly important, both for coronavirus care, but in the long term, working flexibly across sites, especially as increasingly clinicians are having to work at multiple sites rather than in individual hospitals. So why does Bleeper matter? Bleeper represents a shift in the way that we practice clinical medicine. It recognizes that often the specialist skills that we need are not located at the point where we are delivering care, and that we need a dynamic way of sharing that information between those specialists and the people actually delivering care. We hadn't anticipated coronavirus when we designed the product, but it happens that we designed a product that would be the perfect communication tool for this. Almost every patient coming through a hospital has a medical imaging study of one description or another, and medical imaging now forms the cornerstone of almost every clinical decision-making pathway in all hospitals. And therefore, without the ability to display clinical quality medical imaging remotely, you really can't practice effectively from home. So Bleeper is unique in that regard. Additionally, because we handle that quality of medical imaging, we are actually regulated and classed as a certified medical device. And to that extent, we need to actually develop a CE mark, which we are not far from doing, actually. And I am hoping to be able to update in the very near term future about that, which will also support our initiative to help the NHS at this time of need. Bleeper is going to play an increasingly important role, hopefully in supporting the NHS as part of coronavirus. But beyond that, we are hoping that it will continue to have a very active role in supporting numerous care delivery pathways, from pan-regional working models in stroke delivery through to working flexibly at individual hospitals. And I suspect that the medical workforce post-coronavirus will continue to work more flexibly than we have seen in the past, with an increasing amount of home working now that the technical infrastructure should be beginning to grow to be in place. So what's next for Bleeper? Well, we launched Bleeper in December at a pilot site in Manchester with Pennine Acute Hospitals Trust. We had some fantastic initial results from that, where we found that we were able to more than halve the average time it takes to make an inpatient referral and to communicate about a patient between team members. BLEEPA also allowed about 60% of cases to be handled completely within the application, which means that in 60% of cases, those cases could be handled completely from home. Since the onset of coronavirus, the NHS has come under a huge amount of strain, and that is also true at Pennine. And so we have taken the decision with Pennine that actually now is the time to see if we can use BLEEPA to support service delivery much more widely across the trust, particularly as members of staff will have to start to self-isolate and to work from home. So we have paused the pilot, which was focused very much on building pathway-specific workflow tools within respiratory services. And we are now looking at how we can roll out the base functionality to support the diagnosis and management decision-making of patients who are suspected of having coronavirus cases. And we will be evaluating this over the coming weeks with the Trust. And as we roll BLEEPA out across the Trust, we will update the markets accordingly. We hope that the model that we develop within Pennine will be applicable at every NHS Trust across the United Kingdom. And therefore, we'll be also looking to develop a roadmap for extending those learnings to other hospitals. And we have already been making offers to numerous trusts and also to the centre of the NHS in ways that we could support them with BLEEPA. And we hope that once we have proven that case example at Pennine, we will then have the justification to take that out more widely. We have also had interest from the Department of International Trade regarding BLEEPA, and their feeling is that we can similarly support with care delivery overseas. Again, they have all the same pressures facing them in battling and combating coronavirus, and therefore the Department of International Trade compiled a list of 100 UK technologies that they are looking to export as an aid package as part of this response to coronavirus, and we were one of the companies selected for inclusion into that. We also have been included in a catalogue of digital offerings that are being put forward to the NHS by the SETA, who are a specialist advisory group who look at different technologies and how they could be applied. And at this time, they wanted to compile a list of the top performing medical devices that could be used to support coronavirus, and we were similarly in part of that list. So we are hoping that in the near term, we will be able to support the NHS to deliver safe care through BLEEPA. We will be able to support clinicians as they have to self-isolate to continue delivering care as part of core clinical delivery. We also hope to be able to support some of the retired medics who are returning to the front line, but who are themselves more susceptible to exposure to coronavirus. And we hope that BLEEPA may be a way of reintroducing their skills and expertise in a way that allows them to be protected and to stay safe so that they can deliver those expertise from home. So it is a very dynamic space for BLEEPA right now. We feel we have a lot to offer, and we are looking very much to model that at Pennine and then to grow it across the NHS. In the long term, we hope that the rollout that we provide now will provide a brand new imaging infrastructure for the NHS, one that will allow much more flexible and dynamic interaction with medical imaging and will support the exchange of medical imaging between different hospital sites. So we believe that the short-term solution can become part of a much longer-term infrastructure solution for the NHS, and we will be working closely with the NHS to try to deliver that. And that really is our near and long-term vision for the time being. So if there are any questions, I'd be happy to take those now. I appreciate we've finished a little bit early.
Okay, I think that my screen has frozen, but thanks very much, Tom. I mean, you could not have anticipated COVID-19. Speed is of the essence, so I'm just wondering how much pressure you're under as you ramp up your workflow.
Clearly, speed is of the essence. We have to make sure that we get this right and that the tool that we roll out is going to provide what is needed. It's particularly important that we spend the time really ironing out that solution with Pennine to ensure that it works initially for them, but then we'll have the confidence that it will work at other locations in the way. We are a medical device, and we take it.
Hi there. I don't know what's happened with Sarah, so I'm going to ask you some questions that I can see coming through, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, for sure, sure. Yeah, no, please.
Okay, so I can see one that's come through from Liam Boyd here. He's asking, how do you see competition in this area at the moment? Is there anyone else in the same sort of niche as you?
So there are a number of providers who do an instant messaging service. They do not provide clinical grade medical imaging. We are the only tool on the market that does this as part of a communication platform. We're also the only communication platform, therefore, to be registered as a medical device. So it is a really quite unique position that we are in, and our offering is quite unique. That said, a number of tech companies, and it's been fantastic to see actually, a number of tech companies have come forward to offer support to the NHS at this time. We know that in terms of the DIT offer, over 700 companies, probably even more than that actually, in the end, came forward in support. So there are a number of people offering help to the NHS. The difficulty that creates is, of course, that it then makes it very difficult for us to be able to communicate effectively with trusts, who, as well as being overwhelmed with dealing with coronavirus, are also overwhelmed with offers of help and support. Although I appreciate that is a good problem for them to have. However, we are the only application that has this functionality and can support in this way.
Okay. I can see another one's come through from Kenneth here. How close to finishing the Pennine trial were you before having to halt it?
So we were working closely with Pennine in a number of different ways. So part of that was the assessment of Bleeper as a tool. Part of it was also gathering clinical feedback to help us to improve and develop the product and to develop a series of updates that would allow greater functionality. I mentioned that we were using the pilot as a way of building pathways-specific tools, which was very much about addressing how patients moved into the respiratory team within that locality. That's quite a locality-specific function, and it may not have more wider applications. So in terms of where we were with the pilot, we had the initial data response, which we mentioned about being able to more than halve the number of inpatient referrals. Those results were being consistently demonstrated. What we hadn't managed to do was to introduce the second phase of updates to the product, which was something we were hoping to do just as coronavirus struck. So in terms of the actual things we've developed with Pennine, we haven't yet been able to evaluate those. So there is still work to be done on that. And once we have come up with a robust response to the coronavirus crisis, we will look to re-undertake that assessment of those updated but very specific features.
Okay, I can see a few questions here coming through with the same sort of theme, and that is, how well is the company funded to be able to roll this out?
So we raised capital last year, which gave us a sufficient runway, A, to do the initial product development, also to undertake the work required to do the CE marking, of which actually the pilot was a crucial component, because part of doing the CE marking is gathering clinical evidence to support that application, which again, as I indicated earlier, is something that we are imminently close to doing. We have enough cash to get us through to where we need to for the time being. Depending on the speed with which we have to roll this out to the NHS, we may have to consider bringing in some support. The government schemes are certainly very helpful at this time in terms of helping us to increase our runway. And I think really it depends on how quickly we need to go as to how that will affect our cash position and our burn rate.
Okay. Okay. And I can see a question coming in here from Akram. He asks, after this rollout to the NHS, I mean, how transformational do you think this can become? And what sort of figures are we looking at here?
I mean, the reason I'm here doing this is because I genuinely hope and believe that Bleeper will transform the way that we practice. I left clinical practice in part to create this kind of change, using technology to really help frontline delivery. We know that the tool is good. We know that it helps in clinical delivery. We're hoping that we'll be able to demonstrate that to a very large extent with the coronavirus response. Moving on, I hope that this is a tool that is used and adopted by the NHS for many years to come. And hopefully we will see the increasing desire of clinicians to work more flexibly from home as a key driving force behind the adoption of tools like Bleeper.
Okay. A message here from Craig. Please, can you tell us about the shareholder structure? Who owns what? And how much skin in the game does management have?
So we have quite a diverse shareholder ownership. We have two large private individual shareholders. We did bring in some institutional investors in the last funding round. We have an options pool of 12.5% of the company's share capital, which is available for employees as part of an incentive scheme. And management, as part of that, do have options within the company. I think for more information, most of this is publicly available. So,
okay. An interesting spin on it here from Jed Sims. Have there been any developments for Bleeper in the veterinary field?
So I think we indicated a while back that we had had some discussions with veterinary services, which had come as a very pleasant surprise to us. It turns out that they have a number of the same pain points that human healthcare delivery does, in terms of often there's a senior vet who's in the middle of the field, and he or she are the ones that need to give the expert advice to more junior colleagues who remain in the practice. Those conversations are still progressing. We have a number of different opportunities within our sites. It's difficult to know at this time what impact coronavirus is going to have on that. Our primary focus, and I think it needs to be our primary focus, will very much be in getting this offer to the NHS, where it is acutely needed. We have to be mindful that, given our size, what we can deliver and how we can deliver, and therefore we will be prioritising the NHS at this time.
Okay. So at the moment we've got 108 investors in the room, Tom. What should these people be looking out for in terms of upcoming news flow in the next, I don't know, 6 months to 12 months? What should they be looking at to sort of see, you know, this could be a really good time for them to get involved with the company?
So I think in near term, keep your eyes on what's happening in terms of the Pennine support that we'll be looking to develop, particularly around coronavirus. As I said, imminently we'll be expecting to be able to announce about the CE marking. I think also keep an eye on how we will then look to scale the opportunity around supporting the NHS from Pennine out, both within the NHS and then internationally. And then moving forwards into the long term, I think it's very much just keeping pace with the potential national and hopefully international expansion of Bleeper across different healthcare providers. We did mention that Bleeper has capabilities around supporting AI tool deployment, and there are a number of future evolutions of a product that we would consider going forwards. Right now, though, our priority is very much to get the communication tool to the NHS. So look for further news on that in the coming weeks and months.
Brilliant. Tom, thank you very much.